Hey gut feelers, welcome to Hay Fever Friday, the series we do every Friday to support you to overcome your allergies in the most simple and natural way possible, and also to suffer less from the symptoms if you have them already. This episode is especially once you have the hay fever rash. I'm going to share with you three emergency tips that worked best for me once you are in a hay fever rash. Everything is swelling up, you have the red eyes, you have the itchy nose, the running nose, you feel just super tired, just want to sleep in the middle of the day. What to do? I've got three things for you, and then I've also got an extra tip if none of these things are manageable for you, if you're at work and just or somewhere sitting in a train and you can't do any of these things. So stay tuned till the end. Also got a question for you to share your knowledge, what you know already about hay fever with the community. If you're new to this channel, my name is Peggy from peggysharma.com. This channel is called Gut Feelings because it wants to support you to become your own health expert. So you have all the energy you need to get out there, enjoy your life to the fullest, and also bring your gifts in the world. So let's get started right away. Tip number one, what to do if you have a hay fever rash coming up and you need an emergency remedy. You can't take spirulina or do any other kinds of diet changes. You just want something to work. Now, these three emergency tips that I have for you, they work best if you do them in this order. But even if you can just do one of them, you're gonna feel some relief already. So tip number one is the first thing I recommend you to do if the hay fever rash is coming up. It has to do with fruit. What a surprise. If you know this channel, we talk a lot about fruit and how diet helps you to overcome your hay fever. It's connected to oranges. I recommend you to, if you can, get half a liter of fresh pressed orange juice. Sometimes often they do that in the supermarket already, or you might have your own juicer, or you even just have like a lemon squeeze and just squeeze your head off, squeezing like 8 or 10 oranges for this half liter. And what that will do for you, and why to do that first, is because there's vitamin C in there and there's bioactive vitamin C. What vitamin C does for hay fever is that immediately it decongests, helps your mucosa in your nose, it helps to de-swell, it's anti-inflammatory. Basically, the histamine that is released in the tissue that causes your symptoms is an inflammation. So vitamin C helps to be anti-inflammatory, and on the same time, it also strengthens your immune system. By the way, allergies have nothing to do with your immune system being crazy or working against your body. If you want to know more about that, I'll link the central video, what causes allergies, in the end screen for you. But vitamin C really works here. It's antibacterial as well, meaning it also works against the cause of allergies, which is bacterial. And it helps to immediately start decongesting, anti-inflammatory. It's going to help to relieve your symptoms in 30 minutes or less. And that's why I also recommend you to drink juice and not just eat an orange, because then there's no digestive effort for your body and it just works quicker. Drink half a liter, it's like 16, 17 ounces of fresh pressed orange juice. Now I understand if you are at work or you are in university and you're like, where do I get half a liter of fresh pressed orange juice right now? Completely understand that. What you can also do is take a high quality vitamin C supplement. Now I'm not talking about this white powder, which is very aggressive for your body and actually doesn't really work. I talk about a bioactive form of vitamin C. Again, I've recorded a video about the best vitamin C supplements that are actually very body friendly. I'm going to link them in the description below if you want to check that out. That's also an option. Just taking one of the capsules once the hay fever rash starts, or even better, just take them every day. There's nothing wrong with vitamin C. You can't overdose vitamin C. The worst thing that can happen is if you have a bit of diarrhea, but it also happens only if you overdose, really overdose. Emergency tip number one, fresh pressed orange juice or taking a high quality vitamin C supplement. Now, once you've done that and you are at home or you have a bathroom near you, second emergency tip to do is get that face underwater. Fill a sink with cold water and just hold your face in the cold water. That helps to decongest the nose. It also washes out the pollen out of your eyes, the ragweed, whatever you're allergic to, just washes that out. If you can even take a shower, would be even better. Wash that out of your hair as well. Put on fresh clothes because the pollen also sticks to the clothes. Cold water is best because it helps with the inflammation coming down a little bit. And it's also something you probably naturally want to do if everything is swollen up and there's this heat coming up. Yeah, I remember when I had still all these hay fever symptoms that there was just like, I just had felt like my head was double sized and just swollen like a big orange or a big watermelon on top of my neck. Just like, So put your face under water, keep that face under water for some seconds, not too long, of course. Use a fresh towel to dry everything off. And then we come to step number three. That might sound a bit strange for you, but it actually works. Just an emergency tip, it's nothing that attacks the root causes of allergies. Vitamin C does that, by the way. But there are many more things that you can do to really attack the root cause. And check out the other videos all about allergies, where we talk really about getting to the root cause and healing your allergies and not just suppressing them. So now, tip number three. Don't laugh at me, it has to do with coconut oil. So, emergency tip, what you can do is if you have your symptoms in your eyes and in your nose, classical allergy symptoms, what you can do is you get like an earbud like this, and then you roll it a bit in the coconut oil and you apply it to the inside of your nose. You don't have to stick it all up, just a bit inside, like this deep into the nose. And also apply it around your eyes. Yeah, just around your eyes where the eyelashes are. Coconut oil, what it does is that the pollen will actually stick to the coconut because it's pretty greasy and it's moist, and this is where pollen stops, and then it will stop like in the entrance of your nose and it doesn't get up, so you don't have the sneezing and the swelling. The around the eyes as well, here and up there. It also prevents the pollen to get into your eyes. And on top, coconut oil is awesome for your skin. Yeah, it really keeps the skin moist. It's antibacterial, it's also antiviral. So you only do yourself a favor if you try that out. So these are the three tips, and then you're ready to go out again. Yeah, you have your fresh pressed lemon juice inside, you watered your face, you washed out the pollen that already got into your system, and then you apply the coconut oil all around your head, and then you're ready to face the world again and hopefully gonna feel better. I recommend you to take like the vitamin C, if you go for vitamin C capsules, to take 3 per day. Like if you have this emergency rash, just keep going because it's gonna help to keep the inflammation low and just really also attacks the root cause. Let's think you are sitting in a university lecture, or you're sitting at work, or you're in a train, you're on travel, and you can't do any of these things. You can do in addition to these 3 steps and just keep doing that, or if you don't have any other things available. And that's a technique that comes from acupressure, also from acupuncture. You use your 2 fingers, and then you see this part here, just before your eyebrow starts, and you find like a little curve. Yeah, but really, even if you don't find the curve, where your eyebrow starts is that point. And then you put these 2 fingers here, and you basically, you just press pretty firmly for 60 seconds. You can also massage the whole thing a bit. And if it's painful, that's often an indication that you are on the right spot. And what that does is, first of all, it calms your nervous system. That's something I did when I was still in university and I had these hay fever attacks. That really helped me for just slowing down, because I felt this kind of nervousness in my body because there's so much swelling and inflammation. So it helps the nervous system, but its second thing, and that's really for your allergy symptoms, it helps also to decongest the nose and close the inflammation here in the eyes, which also helps your body to deal better with allergies and just balance your system better. At 60 seconds one side, and then you can very relaxed at work go to the other side. It's something you can do. It doesn't look great if you do it like this in the train, but if you just do one like this, nobody will notice. So guys, let's repeat. Fresh pressed orange juice, half a liter, yeah, as soon as something comes up, or take a good vitamin C supplement, linked below. Then second one, have a shower, wash your face with cold water, even hold it under water for a few seconds. And the third one, apply coconut oil around your nostrils and around your eyes to keep the pollen from flowing in. And then fourth one, do the acupressure technique to calm your nervous system and balance your chi. Guys, before we end, I have a question for you to share. What is your emergency recipe that worked for you that you're using when you have this hay fever rash coming up? Share it in the comments below. One sentence is enough, so other gut feelers can also profit from your knowledge that you build up through your own healing journey. Thank you for sharing below. If you haven't subscribed to Gut Feelings, I welcome you. Press the logo and you're going to be subscribed to this channel, and we stay in touch throughout these videos and build a community of health experts and gut feelers who know what's happening inside their body and who create the life they want to. Thanks for watching, guys. I wish you a beautiful day. See you in the next video. Bye bye.